I'ma get kicked out of King's College. I probably shouldn't cheat, but dag, I like carnal knowledge. The problem is I got a lot of head, but no chin. That's it. That's all.
You are right, though. This man has no chin.
Where are Hillary's 33,000 emails? Where's Dinesh D'Souza's chin?
What's the bigger conspiracy?
And as I said before, he does look like a younger Indian version of Mitch McConnell.
He does. He's very turtly.
Turtle. Yeah.
You look at him, you can't not think of fucking Master of Disguise.
Right? What a classic gem of a screen that one is.
Yeah.
And this film is not. Okay, so we're talking about 2016's Hillary's America, not 2012's 2016 Obama's America.
Yeah,
correct.
Just to be as less confusing as possible, as least confusing as possible.
And we're doing this because Dinesh D'Souza was pardoned by Donald Trump for campaign finance violations.
Yeah, he had a couple people pay contributions to a woman's Senate run in New York, and that's a big no-no.
And so it opens with him being persecuted for this, and he says the reason he's persecuted is because
really
of his 2012 film.
Yes, about Obama, Obama's America.
There's like a kernel of truth in this film, in a whole mountain of bullshit.
Yeah,
it's like there's these things that are true, like Andrew Jackson was a Democrat, he owned slaves, he was an asshole. And that just means that every Democrat's an asshole.
Yeah. Democrats owned slaves back then, so therefore if you're a Democrat now, you're wrong and a totally horrible human being.
Exactly. Yeah. Because Democrats were the party of the South, and because they were the party of the KKK in the 1920s, there's no taking into account.
His argument is that American politics fundamentally has not changed in over 200 years.
Yeah.
It's like, are you fucking kidding me?
It's just so stupid.
It is. I mean, and he's been called out many...
It's just so stupid. This is what D'Souza's doing. He's driving Chase to drink, what is it, Chardonnay-nays.
Yeah.
Oh, where did this come from?
Now we got to credit her because her hand's in it.
I mean, that was like a glass filled with Smirnoff, and then you're just doing a splash of Chardonnay for color?
Mm-hmm.
Everybody cringes
it's
off
even
camera.
Better. It's
Chase,
even better.
We know you're not telling the truth.
Okay. I have looked at charts. The southern states, their party affiliation from like 1908 to modern day, it was almost all Democrats. But then the shift starts coming during civil rights and things, and they moved over to the Republican Party, which they forget to mention in this film, were the Civil Rights Party in the 1960s. And just because in the 1860s they voted against a Civil Rights Act by a Republican, like their whole party is screwed.
Yeah, well, that's what propaganda is, right?
Yeah.
I mean, that's what would you do? You just you pick and choose the things that you want to put in and leave out everything else.
Can we talk about just the filmmaking itself?
They spent a lot of money on this movie.
I'm hoping that this was at least intentional. So if you have a basic rule of thirds, right? I mean, there's no look space that you're giving this character. He's on the edge of the frame. He's looking out.
It's supposed to make you uncomfortable.
It's supposed to make you uncomfortable, which I assume they're doing.
Normally, the eye line, you want to follow that eye line and it to be more.
Normally, the person would be over here, and there'd be more space in between or middle.
Mr. Robot uses it effectively.
Effectively.
In this. This is not using it effectively.
No.
This is just a style for style's sake.
That's good.
It's like they're repeating the same clip.
I think they're just having him run through like a range of expressions, okay? And now do surprised.
Yeah.
And now do concerned. And now do fearful.
This is billed as a documentary. And yet everything is fake in it. Like
everything
is fiction. And you know, you can do reenactments of things, but to do this where you make it look like it's actually a news case.
It is my judgment that he be locked up overnight for 8 months in a community confinement center.
To like reenact your own trial and film it and then include it in your film.
Narcissistic.
Narcissism.
In all of the conspiracy sections
and
the intros and outros, if you just replace Democrat with Republican and replace Hillary with Trump.
Yeah.
This stuff is all actually
happening. What's going on today.
And strengthen our enemies. It is totally unacceptable for the President of the United States to reward a dictatorial regime.
We should talk about how he finds out all the secret history of the Democrats and Hillary Clinton is that he goes into the Democratic National Museum and he sneaks into the basement.
Right.
First off, he sees that Abraham Lincoln, a Republican, is on there. So he takes that down and he puts a picture of Andrew Jackson, which, I mean, he should get arrested for that.
Yeah.
But then he goes, he breaks in to the basement and starts finding all the secret history. What other time in our history did a Republican break in to the Democratic National Committee?
Nothing comes to mind.
Nothing. Okay.
Nothing.
Maybe.
No. If it happened, though, I'm sure it would be one of the biggest scandals in American history.
Yeah, you think.
Would it make a president resign, do you think?
Not our president. Not anymore. We get all of these reenactments of things that the Democrats did wrong. I mean, this
of these
stuff,
atrocities.
Sure, this is real atrocities that happened. You can't blame it on the current Democratic Party because these people call themselves Democrats.
And it's weird how, I mean, some of the footage too. When you watch it, like these reenactments are a little too upbeat in tone. You know what I mean? Like,
well, because he's proven his point.
I know. Yeah, it's just it's crazy how like how lighthearted he makes of like these horrible moments.
And it is graphic, and there is a lot of slave whipping and stuff like that, and he's basking in the glory.
Yeah, I know that guy.
You don't shoot a scene this way if you're not glorifying what's happening on
it. Right.
It's slow motion, her getting whipped.
Yeah, I mean, so to jump into it like this too, like with no buildup or context, I mean, it's when you see a scene like that in 13 Years a Slave, it's powerful because the whole
12 years.
God close. Damn it.
You're stuck on that 13 million.
You better cut that out. Fuck.
It was 12 and some change. It was almost 13 years.
If you round up.
When you see it in...
it was a choice.
Yeah. Oh, God.
When you see a scene like that in 12 Years a Slave, it's powerful because the whole film has been building in that tone and everything. But to just throw these, like, you know, horrific moments in American history, like, just into your documentary like this, you know, is... really fucking distasteful. And the way that, and he does it constantly.
Especially because this is American history. It's not just the Democrat history. American history. And then at the end, there's at least 12 minutes. There's four songs that they play in full.
That's what I was about
to say.
They
even do the extra verse of fucking national anthem. That's what it's called.
The Radiohead song. I fucking love that one.
They have this and they glorify it. And then at the end, they have the audacity to have little kids running with an American flag through fields and stuff
so
like that.
So much stock footage.
Fuck off.
Dinesh has this line where he says, well, you'll say, well, Republicans own slaves too. Actually, no.
No
Republicans ever owned a slave.
Ever owned a slave.
But wait a minute, you say. Didn't some Republicans own slaves? Actually, no. No Republicans own slaves.
This is false. But... it's not as false as you'd think, but that's because the Republican Party, when they were formed, they were an anti-slavery party, and they were formed right at the front of the Civil War. So there was only slavery for a couple years. But Ulysses S. Grant, the head of the Republican Party, owned a slave. At an hour and 15 minutes, we finally get into Hillary Clinton. Oh, God, this scene.
Love it. So good.
We gotta play that several times.
He's just so terrified by her. He's like, oh my God, your face.
He throws the notebook in the air before she pushes it.
I mean, he literally looks at her and screams and chucks the notebook. It's really
afraid. And this actress is so bad.
Yeah, the young girl.
It's just like, watch these clips.
Neutrality.
Oh yeah, that's real smart. Mm-hmm.
Unless we take over the government, then we can push from the inside.
The student outsmarted the teacher.
And it goes into Bill Clinton's, you know, Bill Clinton's an asshole. He's the only president I met. He did call me son.
Oh.
And Chase is in need of a father figure.
I did.
He is.
At the time when I was young, I did imagine myself actually being his son for
a
while.
I'm not surprised.
Did you bring a baseball glove to the meeting and just being like, maybe we could go play a little catch?
Dad, I got my rubber band and my leather oil.
Nice. But basically, he blames Hillary Clinton for all the sex scandals.
There's
valid points. Bill Clinton is a sexual predator. That's a valid point, but then...
And if her husband's a sex abuser, how's that her fault? Actually, it is. In many ways, she orchestrated all of this.
Hillary knew early on that he was under sexual abuse. So the fact that he's blaming her for that, and that he's basically saying not only that did she... Was she okay with it happening? She, like, enabled him to keep doing it.
She exploited his weakness.
Yeah.
He has a weakness and a problem, and she exploited it.
It's not Hillary's America. It's, I fucking hate Democrats, and this is what Democrats are going to do to America.
Because of Andrew Jackson. I hate Democrats, Andrew Jackson.
Andrew Johnson sucked. What's his name? Oh, we didn't even talk about this. Woodrow Wilson, also a douchebag. This is one of my favorite parts of the film. For some reason, this film hasn't gotten surreal at all until this point.
Yeah.
One of the KKK horsemen rides out of the screen, and Woodrow Wilson's reaction to him rushing out of the screen is so funny. And then it cuts to the White House lawn, and the horse is like running along the lawn, and Woodrow Wilson's like, ah, crazy KKK, I love him. Just the reaction of Woodrow Wilson in all three of these scenes is just so fucking funny.
He's such a smug son of a bitch. I've moved on.
This film was really hard to watch.
It is.
I hated it. And it's just a bad film. It's bad filmmaking. And that's the worst part,
and I mean,
right?
He's been horrible. He's been called out on his horrible just jumping to conclusions and making up facts and stuff like that before.
All the conspiracy theories.
Yeah,
that
but
he
somehow
propagates.
People are still like, oh, no, make another movie.
He actually is doing another film. The problem with these propaganda filmmakers, like these right-wing filmmakers, is that it's much harder in Trump's America to make a film about that because they run every facet of our government.
Propaganda is being pumped so, you know, fluidly into our mainstream outlets in general.
And
it's hard to, like, follow that up.
I don't think
like,
he can make an optimistic documentary.
Don't believe the hype.
And then it ends with four beautiful songs about America with stock footage.
It's pretty heavy-handed, guys.
Yeah.
If you feel like
to
getting
say the
your
least.
Fucking face raped by crazy conspiracy propaganda for an hour and 40 minutes, go ahead and give it a shot. Otherwise, you can rate it on Amazon and maybe give it 1 out of 5 stars. That would be helpful to the movement.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right. Well, thanks, everyone, for joining us on this video version of our podcast. We'll be back soon with another episode. Rate and review us. Subscribe to us on YouTube right there. Click that button.
Double-click it, maybe.
And vote for Beto O'Rourke in September if
Definitely.
You're in Texas.
Beto is better. So vote Beto.
How's that?
I say that on every time.
Guys, stay woke.